The desperate wails of a starving horse.
It was horrendous. Never have I heard something like this.
Collapsing metres from her yearling at the Barmah National Park, she's one of dozens of Brumbies succumbing to starvation after a combination of drought and floods destroyed much of their habitat and food source.
Got all these wounds from where she's been falling over trying to look after her foal, and you're thinking, how could this possibly be happening? And it's happening right in our own backyard.
Mm. Driving through this place or riding a horse through, it just looks like an animal cemetery at the moment.
It's illegal to feed native or introduced animals in national parks.
It's not sustainable, and the best we can do is have humane treatment of those animals that have got to that critical condition.
The RSPCA says it's recommended euthanisation previously, but is now urgently seeking more information from Parks Victoria, which has increased patrols and put down 18 animals.
The ones in marginal area, we don't know why they're not moving into feed. In places, they're only 1 or 2 kilometres away from food, and it may be about the dynamics in these feral horses.
Locals say they've witnessed many more dying, spreading into populated areas searching for food, rescuing this mare and foal this week.
We can't get to all of the horses, so what we're doing is a part solution. We've also been threatened with being charged.
Volunteers have now resorted to coaxing horses onto private land to hand feed them donated hay. They're driving hundreds of kilometres every day and spending thousands of dollars just to keep them alive.
If it was horses on our property, we would be criminally charged.
I personally believe that this is a deliberate cull that they've always wanted.
In Barmah, Lana Murphy, 9 News.